how big is your focus on the mergers and acquisitions, advisory? Because in equity market transactions, you've done a lot. But M&A, is that something also you're focusing on for this year and which sectors?
Yeah, so we have also done one of the largest M&As this year too. And of course, the cross-border talks are at the highest. I must say that the India-US relationships have continued to improve. So people are looking at us quite actively to, acquire companies or do JVs. So India is definitely looked at.
Which sectors are we talking about most, which will be active in cross-border, especially with
US? So consumer sector is one of them, where clearly there is a necessity. In JVs, defense continues to be pretty active, if I may say. Also on some of the special commodities, things like that, there is a two-way dialogue which is happening because steel prices are looking good. And of course, one of the things which can become an active market could be the distressed debt market. People are waiting for clarifications that could bring in some more money, which would actually increase our flows to India. And one should not forget, I think REITs is going to become important in the coming months.
Corporate social responsibility is also an integral part of every corporate house. And every year you come up with a paper which DASRA releases, and then you decide on your CSR activities as well. So throw more light on this year's paper and the findings of that.
This year's paper is to say that while individually, each of us as corporates really can influence, and we do our bit, but as a community, how can we adopt, common causes like food security, economic security, adolescent girls and intervention, and how can we have a collaborative around that, and then showcase and learn from the collaborative as you go along, because you would do interventions, you would do, different gatherings, and see how on the ground we can make an influence. So the collaborative is around adolescent girls. It's actually on four interventions, if I may say so. It's to kind of continue for the girl to continue being educated, continue to go to school, right? Continue to have a late marriage and not be pregnant early. If we can really go through 10 to 19 in this fashion and have more women, you'll have a lot more confident India than, and I do believe in women power just like you do, right? And the whole idea is that this collaborative we are actually doing in Jharkhand. That's what DASRA has found it as the most important area right now. And we are working with actually right now, four NGO partners, which will grow as a period over a period of time. And the idea is to see these interventions through these NGOs in all these different aspects that I talked about, and then measure the impact, and then influence the policy around it. And then we have a lot more meat on the table, because we are living far off than what the reality is. But India can become better. India's GDP can become better if we do interventions at the grassroots level.
I just wish you luck in this particular endeavor of Bank of America Merrill Lynch. Thank you so much, Kaku, on that good note. Let me thank you for spending time with us, and we will connect again on the overall deal scenario and market developments as and when they really unfold.
Thanks, Nisha. It's been great being with you.
Thank you so much. So with that, we end Big Deal. Thanks so much for tuning in to CNBC TV 18.